My name is Russell Housen with the Piano Outlet in Margate, Florida. And today I'd like to demonstrate to you how you would set up your piano once it arrives to your house with the iPad. This piano is set up with Piano Disc IQ, and it's set up in order for it to play with the iPad wirelessly. When you get your piano, first of all, it's going to look like this, incidentally, because this one is on its way out. It's going up to Boston to one of our customers, and as you can see, the piano is beautiful. It looks like brand new, and that's how all our pianos leave here. So the first thing you do when the piano comes in is you're going to locate the power cord, which is underneath the back of the piano by the rear leg. You're going to plug it into the power source and then make sure the power strip is turned on. The power strip will power up the piano, and then you will notice underneath the piano there will be LED lights lit up on the IQ box and on the CPU and on the speaker. Once that happens, the piano is ready to play. First thing you do is you grab your iPad and you open it up, turn it onto the desktop, and you will see a place in there where it says settings. You hit settings, and then you locate Wi-Fi. And then what will happen is that the iPad will search for all open networks, and when you see where it says Apple Network, you select that, which we have selected here. You then go back into your desktop. You hit the icon for iPod, and then you will see all your songs, all your albums come up that we've loaded there in for you. I like to start off maybe something like the Ray Charles album here. Oh, the one thing that we want to do is we want to make sure down here in the bottom, the volume control box, both knobs, this one is piano, this one is audio, both of them is turned down as far as they can go, because we don't want it starting up and the piano being overpowered. So let's pick the first song here. Now, as soon as you do that, you'll notice this sound might come from the iPad. It sounds like a computer fax. What that means is that you have to set the iPad to send the signal to the Airport Express rather than have it come out itself. So you want to select base station here. Now the song is playing. What you want to do is very slowly turn up the piano and the audio.
When you kiss me, fever when you hold me tight. Fever in the morning. Fever all through the night.
Sunlights of the daytime.
You can hit play. You could also select a different song by going back out. Let's pick Rod Stewart. Let's say we want to hear this one here. And that one will stop playing. You can control the volume of the piano or the audio by the balance control box here.
Someday, when I'm awfully low.
Another important thing, this volume control box does have an A-B switch because it has two sources. So if for some reason you're not getting a signal, there's a little button on the left, press it, and you might switch it back to the source for the iPad. We'll turn this back on by pressing play.
But it's cold, I will feel a glow just thinking of.
So I'm going to let the camera pan around the piano so you can see it while you're listening to Rod Stewart.
You're so lovely, with your smile so warm, and your cheeks so soft, there is nothing for me but to love.
Okay, one thing I want to do is review again the settings. Case that you didn't get it the first time, when you get your iPad, you want to click settings here. You want to go into Wi-Fi and let the iPad select Apple Network, and then we call that up. Then we go back into the desktop, we select iPod again, select an album,